हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम गणेश बियागलावे, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। इन दिस सेशन वी विल सी थियरी एंड डिज़ाइन ऑफ कार्बोरेटर पास्ट सेकंड लर्निंग आउटकम। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिज़ाइन द सिंपल कार्बोरेटर एंड ऑल्सो विल बी एबल टू इवेल्युएट डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स ऑफ सिंपल कार्बोरेटर। Now, in the previous session, we have seen the introduction of simple carburetor. So there we have seen the air is flowing in the downward direction, as this is the downdraft type of the carburetor, and the fuel injection is from this tube. So we'll consider the section 1-1 at the inlet, section 2-2 at the throat, and you can consider this as the section CC or 3. This is the throttle valve, and this is the difference between the height. The nozzle tip is getting opened over here, so this is considered as a reference line, and the petrol level in the fluid chamber, we'll assume it is to be constant, so this is the Z. Now, we'll use the different relations, and then we'll try to get the air fuel ratio. For that, required mass of air and mass of fuel. Now, considering compressibility of air means there is change in the density. For air, applying steady flow energy equation at section 1-1 and section 2-2. So for that, we can use the relation which you have studied in previous subjects. So try to recall steady flow energy equation. You might have studied in the basic mechanical engineering in the first year. Yes, so it is the steady flow energy equation, which is also called in the short form SFEE. So H1 plus C1 square by 2 plus Q is equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2 plus W. So this is the section 1-1, this is the section 2-2. Okay. So this is the your steady flow energy equation. This is the enthalpy at the inlet, this is the velocity of the fluid at inlet, and this is the heat supplied, which is equal to enthalpy at section 2-2, that is throat, velocity at a throat, and this is the work developed by the fluid. Now, if we pass the fluid through the pipe, it won't develop any work done. So for that purpose, W can be neglected over here. And as I have told you, complete carburetor is insulated one. So there is no heat transfer. So from this equation, I can neglect Q and W. Then you just solve for, so Q and W will be neglected, then what is remaining? H1 plus C1 square by 2, which is equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2. Okay. Now, in this case, C1 is to be neglected once again, because it is C1 is having very small quantity. Okay. That's why usually it is neglected. So what is remaining? C2 square by 2 is equal to H1 minus H2, that is written here. So C2 will be square root of 2 in the Cp in the bracket T1 minus T2, because enthalpy H1 could be replaced by Cpt, okay, and H2 also Cpt2. So what will happen? The H1 minus H2, Cpt1 minus Cpt2. So Cp is taken common, then thus the velocity at throat can be calculated if we know the temperature of the surrounding air, inlet air, and the throat temperature of the air. Okay, next. Now I can take a T1 common, so equation will become C2 is equal to square root of 2 Cp T1 in the bracket 1 minus T2 by T1. Okay, now try to recall the Cp of air. If not given, we are assuming 1.005. Okay, next equation. is square root of 2 Cp T1 in the bracket 1 minus. Now T2 by T1 could be replaced by P2 by P1 because flow through carburetor is once again assumed to be isentropic. In that case, we can replace T2 by T1 by P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay, then you just go on reducing it, then you will be getting the mass of air relation is equal to P1 A2 by R square root of T1 under square root of main square root of 2 Cp in the bracket P2 by P1 raised to 2 by gamma minus P2 by P1 raised to gamma plus 1 by gamma bracket complete. Now this is the theoretical relation. Whenever any fluid flows through tube, pipe, then its coefficient of discharge is to be considered, because theoretical flow cannot be equal to practical flow. Practical flow depends upon the material used for that pipe or tube and its friction factor. So the manufacturer is supplying you this coefficient of discharge. That's why the actual mass flow rate of air is the multiplication of CD into MA. So you can calculate this one. Now for fuel, we can apply the Bernoulli's theorem. So this is the Bernoulli's theorem. Okay, so now here we are going to calculate for the fuel. So the fuel pipe, okay, and the your float chamber. In the float chamber, atmospheric pressure section CC or section 33 we have assumed, and at the throat the pressure is 2. Okay, so here this is the P3. P3 is nothing but CC pressure, and what pressure is acting in the float chamber? Atmospheric pressure. So P1 and P3 are same, so I can replace P3 by P1 also. So this is P3 by rho f plus C1 square by 2 is equal to P2 by rho f plus C2 square by 2 plus GZ. Now this C2 is nothing but velocity of a fuel injected at the throat. Okay, now as C1 is very very small, can be neglected, then P1 is also equal to P3. So this equation I can reduce for C2, then we will get velocity of fuel injected at the throat is equal to square root of 2 by rho f in the bracket delta p minus rho f gz. Now what is the delta p? Delta p is the difference in the pressure, that is P1 minus P2. P1 minus P2. For delta P is equal to 0, mass of fuel injection is going to be 0. With decrease in the P2, mass of fuel increases. Okay, just keep in mind that point. So this is the velocity of fuel injected at the throat. From continuity equation, we can write. So what is continuity equation? Recall? Yes, M is equal to rho A C. Okay. Now, so mass of fuel after substituting in the rho A C, here rho F A 2F and C2. So AF as it is written Z. Now, if they don't give in the numerical the value of the Z, you can neglect this one. So remaining parameter will be 2 rho f delta p. Okay, now here also take, now here what you can do, in the previous equations we have derived ma and here mf, so you can take ma by mf, you will be getting the air fuel ratio. Now we will consider the second case, neglecting means the density will remain constant, then I can apply the Bernoulli's theorem. So P1 by rho A plus C1 square by 2 is equal to P2 by rho A plus C2 square by 2. Now this equation is for air, that's why here suffix AA is written. Neglecting A1 and writing the equation for C2, square root of 2 P2 P1 minus P2 by rho A. from the continuity equation I can write m a is equal to a 2 square root of 2 rho a delta p. So here also neglecting the compressibility, obviously actually the air is compressible, but if you are interested to find approximate air fill ratio, then you can adopt neglecting compressibility. Then actual air flow rate as usual is equal to coefficient of discharge into theoretical air fill, theoretical mass flow rate of air. So this is the third equation. So we'll be having the two air fill ratios. First air fill ratio based on compressibility, second air fill ratio neglecting the compressibility. Okay, so depending upon your accuracy you can select it. Now you can take once again the air fill ratio and you can compare it. It is always recommended to use the accurate or compressibility of the air, accurate method and approximate method. For the accurate method you have to assume the air to be compressible. For more study you can refer IC engine fundamentals by Haywood and second book fundamentals of IC engine by H.N. Gupta, and from these two books you can solve the numericals also. Thank you all.